Hey everyone, in this video we'll briefly cover parameters within FMOD Studio. Let's just jump right into it. Go to a window and press Parameters Browser, and you'll see that we have a Parameters tab open here. Parameters are extremely simple. They are pretty much just numbers that can be connected to almost any value of your game. For example, player health, material values, or win speed. To make that connection between a value in your Unreal Engine game and FMOD, we need to first define a parameter within FMOD Studio. In our previous videos, we made a simple wind event, so we used that one as a basis for our logic. A common variable for something like wind is wind strength or wind speed. So let's make that one. Right-click within this Parameters tab. And if you want to work a little bit more organized, I suggest using folders. I'll make a folder called Ambient. And then I right-click on this Ambient folder and select New Parameter. Alright, a new window has opened and let's go from top to bottom here. We start with parameter type. Let's open up this drop-down and start with the simplest to understand. You see all these built-in parameter types? All these built-in types will not need you to set any values through your game. They are automatically set based on the 3D aspects of your event. For example, what's the distance to the listener, what's the direction of the event, the orientation, how fast is the event moving, etc. Now most of the time, you'd want to set some variable from your game manually to FMOD. We have three parameter types that start with user to choose from. Continuous is a float value. It can have floating point values such as 0.5, 6.77, etc. Discrete is basically just integers or whole numbers. And with labeled, we can set a name for these whole numbers. I personally try to use labeled parameters for things like material, state of music, etc. They make things super readable and will only benefit you in the long run. For our wind event, we want a parameter called wind strength. So let's say the value would be between 0 and 1, 0 is no strength and 1 being fill strength. We choose continuous as our parameter type. Our parameter name would be wind strength. Our range between 0 and 1. And initially, we want to just have a tiny bit of wind, so let's set it to 0.5. Now before adding this parameter to our event, let's quickly cover what's still left in this window. Parameter scope just tells you if whatever value you set is set per event, locally, or should be shared through all of our events, globally. Wind is, for example, globally most of the time, since the wind strength is usually the same through your entire level. By setting it globally, we only need to set it once in our game, and all our events where we use this parameter can benefit from the same value. If you'd do that locally, you'd have to set the wind strength parameter on every event that you play again and again. Before we change it to globally, let's quickly look at what exposed recursively via event instruments means. It basically just makes sure that if you have an event within an event, called a nested event, that those nested events share the same value of the parameter you've set. In our case, we're using globally, so this is not relevant. Read-only makes it impossible to set a parameter from game code. But still, it's possible by automation within FMOD Studio. Hold value during playback makes sure that no matter if the game code changes the parameter during the playback of an event, whatever automation happens because of our parameter does not apply during the playing of the event. So let's press OK because we don't want these two options to be enabled. And now we have this wind strength parameter. I'll quickly press Ctrl S to save, and I can close this window for now. To end this video, we'll do a simple volume automation on our wind event based on the wind strength parameter we just made. Open up your wind event and click this little plus button and select Add Parameter Sheet. I'm browsing to our newly made parameter, which is wind strength, and I click on it. Now that we are in the parameter sheet and not on the timeline, let's right-click the volume knob of the Audio 1 logic track and click Add Automation. On the top of your timeline, you see that we are no longer working in time values. We're now working in values of wind strength between 0 and 1. On 0, we'll make a point on our automation of our volume track, and we'll bring that all the way down to minus infinity decibels. At the end here, at 1 wind strength, we'll make another point and we'll drag that all the way up to 0 decibels. I just like to grab the little point in the middle and make just a bit of a curved top, but that's a little bit up to you. Now we basically have set up our wind strength parameter. Let's play our event and kind of look what happens when we influence the wind strength parameter, either on the right side here or on the top here. Thank you so much for watching this video and stay tuned for the next one.